I am Dr. Monica Agarwal, consultant obstetrics and gynecology with the prestigious institute taking care in mother and child, the Bharat Bliss Hospital at Panchkula. Today I am going to tell you about lactation counseling, all the merits and medical considerations associated with the same. As you can see in this slide, this is the tallest and the most beautiful building of the world, that is the Burj Khalifa, and it has a very strong and deep foundation on which this building stands tall. In a similar fashion, for a strong physical, mental and emotional development of a healthy baby, we need a strong foundation, and breastfeeding gives us that foundation. Now, breastfeeding is the best gift or the best portion that the mother can give to her child. Why do I say this? Because of the following reasons. First of all, the close physical contact creates a very strong emotional bond between the mother and the child, and it provides best nutrition to the baby. It gives protection from various diseases to the baby, like respiratory and diarrheal diseases. It is estimated that millions of deaths can be prevented in the world if we give breast milk to all the babies. It is easily digested. It has a very low cost, because buying the formula or the sterilizing equipment, that costs a lot. It has many positive effects on the mother's health also. It causes early retraction of the uterus, that is, the uterus returns to the normal postpartum pre-pregnancy size very quickly if the mother breastfeeds the baby. She has the a less incidence of postpartum depression, because breastfeeding produces a lot of happy hormones in the mother. Long-term effects are the mother has lesser incidence of serious illnesses like breast cancer, ovarian cancer, diabetes, and she is also less likely to become overweight. Breastfeeding also delays the next pregnancy. Now, we'll come to the recommendations of various international bodies like WHO and UNICEF. WHO and UNICEF recommend initiating breastfeeding within the first half to 1 hour of delivery of the baby. Also, the baby should be fed 6 months of exclusive breastfeed. What does exclusive mean? Exclusive breastfeeding means that the baby should not be given any other food or drink, not even water, in addition to the breast milk. Only the medicines or certain drops prescribed by your doctor can be given. The baby should be given 8 to 12 feeds per day. It should spend 10 to 20 minutes per breast, and while feeding, swallowing sounds are usually audible. They are also visible. Further, the mother can continue breastfeed up to 2 years of age with complementary feed. What are the various types of breast milk? Within a first few days of delivery of the baby, mother produces a thick yellowish fluid which is very less in amount, called as colostrum, but it is very sufficient for the baby, because the baby's capacity is also less. Later on, after a few days, the mother produces mature milk. Pore milk is produced early in the process, and it is thin and watery. It basically quenches the thirst of the baby. Hind milk is produced late. It is thick and white because of the milk solids and fat, and it satisfies the hunger of the baby. Here I would like to stress upon colostrum, because colostrum has a lot of myths associated with it. Parents usually do not feed the baby with colostrum, but it should be definitely fed to the baby. Because of these reasons, it has a lot of antibodies which protects against infective illnesses. It has a lot of white blood cells which give maturity to the gut or the alimentary canal of the baby. The initial stools, which are very thick, tarry, called meconium, they are expelled with the help of colostrum, because it has a laxative action on the baby. It has various types of growth factors. It is vitamin A rich, so also it should be given. Here, I would like to mention some demerits of the artificial feed for the baby and the mother. Obviously, there will be less bonding between the two. The baby will be perpetually ill with diarrheal and respiratory diseases. It will be malnutrited, vitamin A deficient. There is increased incidence of allergy and milk intolerance because the formula has a lot of foreign proteins in it, which cause allergy to the baby. The baby might become overweight, and in long term, it might score low in the intelligence IQ tests. Mother may become pregnant very soon. In the long term, she might have increased incidences of breast and ovarian cancer as well as diabetes. She may also become overweight. Here in this slide, I would like to tell a phenomena that is nipple confusion. The baby is very small and so is the baby's intelligence. So if we offer the baby artificial dummy or the nipple very early in life, it becomes confused what to take. This is the easy way, and taking breast milk, suckling is very tough. Baby, if given nipple or dummy very early in life, becomes confused and is drawn towards the easy way. So we should not offer the baby artificial dummies very early in life. Now, what is the composition of the breast milk? Breast milk is ready-made feed for the baby at the right temperature with no contaminants. Formula, however we prepare it, it is contaminated with pollutants and various bacteria. So, and the breast milk has many anti-infective factors, it has growth factors, the quality and the quantity of protein is right in amount, the proteins are very easily digested, it has essential fatty acids, iron, though very less in amount in the breast milk, it is very well absorbed by the baby, and hence the breastfed babies are not anemic. They also get enough vitamin and enough water, so we do not need to give the baby extra water or any vitamin drops. Here I would like to tell you how does it work. The basic hormone which is responsible for the production of breast milk is prolactin. It is produced in the brain of the mother from the pituitary gland, and the positive feedback for prolactin is suckling. The process of suckling leads to increased production of prolactin, which leads to increased milk production, so on and so forth. Hence, the baby itself decides for itself how much milk does the milk mother produce. If the baby suckles more, more prolactin is produced and more milk is produced, and the vice versa. Prolactin also suppresses ovulation and delays fertility of the mother. This now I would like to stress upon the oxytocin reflex. This is a reflex which helps in the flow of the milk or milk let down. This reflex has certain positive feedbacks and certain negative feedbacks. The sight, sound, even the thought of the baby causes a positive reflex on the oxytocin reflex. And confidence of the mother, basically that she can breastfeed the baby, has also a very positive effect on the reflex. On the other hand, various emotions like worry, stress, if the mother has pain somewhere, or she has a doubt that she cannot feed her baby, has a lot of negative effect on the reflex and the milk does not flow. So it is basically the role of the husband and the society and the healthcare facilities to increase the confidence of the mother and decrease her doubts regarding breastfeeding. Here, I have shown a slide about good attachment. This is the internal view and this is the external view. And these two slides are showing the poor attachment of the baby to the breast. Here, as you can see, the mouth of the baby is wide open. Most of the areola is inside the baby's mouth and the nipple is touching the back of the throat of the baby. In this position, both the mother and the baby are comfortable. Mother does not have any kind of pain and baby is getting enough milk. Here in poor attachment, the mouth is not very wide open, areola is not inside the mouth, and nipple is not touching the back of the throat. This can cause a lot of discomfort and pain to the mother and poor milk supply to the baby. What are the causes of poor attachment? The first and foremost cause of poor attachment is use of bottle. If we offer the baby bottle very early in life, it will not be able to attach to the breast. Secondly, if the breast is engorged or it is overfilled, or the baby is very small or weak, and both mother and baby do not have a skilled support and family support, can lead to poor attachment. Poor attachment causes a lot of pain in the nipples, it causes cracked nipples, engorged breasts, because the breasts are not able to empty properly, so they are engorged. Baby will not get the enough milk, the baby will be hungry, frustrated, lead to constipation, and ultimately the baby will not gain weight. Now here, what is the solution to all these problems? In earlier times, there used to be joint families, and the older ladies of the family used to teach new mother the art of lactation, and it used to come very naturally to the mothers. Nowadays, with increasing nuclear families, new mothers don't have any support, and hence we have to give professional support to the mothers to learn the art of lactation, because it is really an art only. Secondly, we also have to teach the baby how to take the breast. Success is achieved if the mother is motivated, and this motivation has to start in pregnancy itself. Whenever the mother touches any healthcare facility, we have to motivate her regarding breastfeeding there and then, and we have to have positive reinforcement in each and every visit of the mother. Positioning of the baby, proper positioning of the baby, goes a long way in success. Frequent suckling leads to increased breast milk production, and it is also a very good thing. Now, the professional support to the mother for the proper teaching and position is also important. Here I will like to stress upon the role of healthcare facility. The role of healthcare facility is very important in initiating and maintaining the breastfeeding. Every healthcare facility should have a strong breastfeeding policy, a written policy, which should be known to each and every staff. Training of the staff should be proper. Counseling of pregnant babies should be there in each and every visit. We should help the mother to initiate breastfeeding within half an hour of delivery of the baby. Proper demonstration of the technique should be there. The baby should not be offered any other feed or drink other than breast milk. Now, a word or two about rooming in. Rooming in is a very good policy. It is a positive policy in which the baby is shifted in the mother's room day and night. In this, the baby cries less often, and the mother is able to respond to the baby's demand as soon as the baby cries. And hence, it leads to increased breastfeeding. Mother is more confident in dealing with the baby. The baby has to be given on-demand feed, means we do not need to have very strict timetables for the baby. Whenever the baby demands, we can feed the baby. Here, we should not have any artificial pacifiers or dummies should be offered to the baby, because it gets confused and nipple confusion occurs. We have to give confidence to the parents. Here, I would like to mention, not only the mother, but the husband and the entire family needs to be reinforced about the importance. And they are the people who will give support to the mother while she is breastfeeding. Positive reinforcement to the mother, encourage the mother all the time, praise her for her efforts. These all things go a long way in success. Now, I have enumerated various breastfeeding positions are there. Football hold, cradle hold, cross body, crossover, and lying down. But the bottom line is, if the position is comfortable, any position which is comfortable for both the mother and baby can be used. After the mother has fed the baby, to remove it from the breast, we do not have to pull the baby as such. It will cause injury to the nipple. Hence, the mother should first release the suction by inserting her finger in the corner of the baby's mouth. And lastly, burping of baby is very important because it swallows a lot of air along with breast milk, and hence burping has a very important role. Here I have told you the various positions. This is the demo of the positions. The most common position is the cradle position. In this, the head is in the crook of the elbow and the baby is fully facing the mother, tummies are touching and it is feeding. Cross cradle is almost like cradle except for the opposite arm holds the baby. Football position is basically for cesarean mothers. In this, the baby's weight is not on the mother's tummy and it does not pressure that area. The baby is held on the side of the mother and the face is facing the mother and she is feeding. In sideline position, the mother and baby are both lying down facing each other and mother is feeding the baby. Here, as you can see that the mother has used a lot of pillows to support the baby. This is very important because the mother should not bend over or have postural problems while feeding. A lot of pillows should be used to support the baby's weight. What problems can we face while breastfeeding? The mother could have flat or inverted nipples. She could have long or big nipples. The breast could be overfilled or engorged. The ducts could be blocked. The breast could have mastitis. There could be cracked nipples. But remember, all these conditions are treatable and early diagnosis is important for management of these conditions so that we can relieve the mother and let her continue with the breastfeeding. There are various shapes and sizes of breast all over the world, but all these shapes are able to lactate their baby. Now, in clinical practice, often this is the most common problem that we encounter, that mothers feel that they do not have enough milk. And due to this reason, either they stop breastfeeding or they start complementary feed too early in the life. Now, to tell you all, almost all mothers can produce enough milk for their babies. In fact, they can feed two babies at a time. In earlier times, there used to be wet nurses which used to feed their baby as well as another baby. You should remember that baby is getting all it needs. What you need to monitor is the baby's weight and the urine output. The normal weight gain is around 500 grams per month or 125 grams per week. But for easy assessment, means for day-to-day assessment, you can see the urine of the baby. If the baby is producing dilute normal urine 6 times a day, it is enough. It is well. Dilute, by dilute urine we mean the urine's color should be white or light yellow and it should not be strong smelling. If the urine is very dark yellow or orangish and it has a very strong smell, then you need to contact your doctor. Another reason is excessive crying. Parents think that if the baby is crying, then enough milk is not being given and they discontinue with it. But you should remember that if the baby is crying too much, it is not necessarily hungry. There are various reasons of crying, like the baby could be in discomfort. Discomfort could be due to wet nappy, or the baby could be too hot, too cold. You have to check everything. The baby could be tired. It could be because of illness, pain. Hunger comes very low in the list of crying. Sometimes mother's food, like a new food, peanut, or some allergen in the food can irritate the baby. Mother's drugs also have an effect on the baby. Baby could be having colic. Colic usually is pain, intestinal pain due to gas, and it disappears by 2 to 3 months of age. Sometimes it is in general a very high needs baby which needs a lot of comforting. So, and here I would like to stress one point more. If we always feed the baby, if the baby is crying, it gets the notion that food is something comforting. I have to take food whenever there is some problem, and this continues into adulthood. The individuals also think that food is a comfort factor, and this can lead to obesity. Low birth weight and sick babies need a special mention. The low birth weight babies are whose birth weight is less than 2500 grams. They need breast milk even more than term babies. And nature has very well adapted preterm milk according to the preterm babies, because preterm milk is higher in terms of proteins and antibodies. But the various methods of feeding the baby are different. If the baby is less than 30 to 32 weeks, then it cannot suckle. So we have to feed the baby with the help of a tube which goes through the nose and settles in the stomach of the baby, and we have to give breast milk, express breast milk via a syringe. Sometimes babies between 30 to 32 weeks, they can take milk by small cups or spoons. More than 32 weeks may suckle, but will need cup in between. Here I mention cup because cup is always better than bottle in terms of sterilization, in terms of cleanliness. And another thing, the person who is feeding with the help of cup has the same bond with the baby, the position is same, and the baby does not feel that it is left out. So cup should be used instead of bottles. Lifestyle of a feeding mother needs to be special. Of course, she needs a lot of nutrition in form of fruits, vegetables, whole grains, proteins. But she needs only 500 extra calories per day. Anything more than that will add to the weight of the mother. Now, people sometimes think that fluids are not necessary for a feeding mother. But breast milk is 99% water and only 1% solid. So we need a lot of fluid to the tune of 3 liters so that good amount and good frequency of milk is produced. Always ask your doctor before taking any drug, because the drugs always pass in breast milk and can affect your little one. Caffeine should be taken in moderate amounts, and rest is very necessary because during resting, mother produces a lot of milk. Obviously, you should not smoke, and there is no amount of alcohol which can be safe for feeding mothers. Now, a word about working mothers. Working mothers have a lot of anxiety about breastfeeding. They are very much anxious how to do that. So the advice would be, they can feed their baby exclusively and frequently till they are on leave. And they can just start the feed 2-3 days before they are about to join their job, and it should not be started too early. They can continue with the night feed and whenever they are at home if they have joined. Working mothers especially, they should learn how to express the milk soon after delivery, and they can give express breast milk to the baby whenever they are away. They should keep a very big chunk of time for expressing milk, and after milk expression, they can always feed the baby. Teach the caregiver properly and carefully to take care of your loved one. How to express milk for working mothers especially? Milk expression can be either manual or with the help of a pump. It should be stored in clean containers or special bottles made for the same purpose. The storage is very easy. It can be stored at room temperature for 6 hours, refrigerated for 8 days, or they can be frozen. The breast milk can also be frozen for 6 to 12 months. Now, there are two processes called as induced lactation and relactation. This is the process of starting breastfeeding. Induced lactation is in the women who have not given birth with proper stimuli. It can be started. Relactation is if for certain reason, because of mother's illness or the child's illness, if there has been a break in breastfeeding, then breastfeeding can again be started. Relactation can be done with the help of proper stimuli. Now, as you all know, marketing means selling things, selling by any means. But this does not apply to breast milk substitute. There is a strict international code of marketing for substitute. Here I have elaborated the code. There should be no advertising of substitute to the public. The mother should not be provided any free sample. No promotion in the healthcare facility. The company personnel are not advised to meet the mother. No pictures of infants are displayed on the label. All the information has to be very scientific and factual. Benefits of breastfeeding should be labeled on the labels and should be told to the mothers. Formula has to be used, means why to make the formula. Formula should be used only as a last resort. There are certain medical considerations, means the situations in which we do not ask the mother to breastfeed the baby because it could harm the baby. These conditions are, if the mother is HIV positive, then she can transmit the virus to her baby. If the mother has active untreated tuberculosis, it is also dangerous. If the mother is on certain drugs like chemotherapy for cancer or certain medications for migraine, Parkinson's disease or arthritis, these medications can harm the baby. So we advise against breastfeeding. And in the last, if the baby has galactosemia and cannot tolerate the galactose in milk, then also breastfeeding is not done. In the last, I would like to elaborate upon the reasons why mothers do not feed the baby. Firstly, mothers are sometimes very shy to feed the baby in public, and so they do not opt for breastfeeding. The mother sometimes likes the flexibility that she is not only the primary caregiver for the baby. Every time commitment of feeding every few hours may not be possible for every woman. And the biggest problem is the fear of cosmetic problems. Women think that if they feed their baby, then cosmetically sagging will occur and they will not look good. Let me assure you, see, breastfeeding does not cause sagging. There are various other reasons. Gravity is always working. With proper guidance, with proper support, cosmetic problems really do not occur. And if you compare the health benefits with cosmetic problems, you should always opt for breastfeeding because it has a lot of health benefits also. Thank you for your patient listening. The take-home message today, I would like to say that substitute can never replace the original. This you have to keep in mind. And if you have any further queries, I would love to answer them. I'm available at the Bharat Bliss Hospital at Panchkula. Thank you very much.